Okay, so let's get started. Would you please describe what you do in a typical day?
Sure. I am a project manager in the software engineering department with Chablik Technologies. Chablik Technologies is the market leader in simplification of complex enterprise network configuration, compliance, and security. And on a daily basis, when I start my day, I'm responsible for around 3 to 4 projects to manage. I have a very clear tasks set for a full team that I manage with those projects. And I start my day by understanding if anything changed in the priorities based on a business need, a customer changing their mind, or any other reason for a change. And then I communicate this quickly to the team to make sure that we digest that, we react and adapt very quickly as a team. If nothing changed, most likely I would be working very closely in planning those projects, see what's the next phase that we are going into, who's involved, what type of resources we need, what's the budget around that, what's the timeline, communicate this to the whole team, communicate it to the stakeholders and the executives within the company, and make sure that everyone is on the same page. Other part of my daily job is there are some of the projects that didn't start yet that we need as a management team to set a vision and set expectations and to plan ahead of time before we start resourcing those projects. So this is how my daily day activities looks like.
So would you please describe what kind of jobs and experiences have led you to your current position?
I started in different places before joining Chablik Technologies. I started working as a Java developer in Jordan with an internet software development company, where I had the chance to start exploring how to do development, software development, and what kind of tools and technologies are there. And then I moved to the States with Boston Scientific, the cardiac rhythm management, previously known as Guidant, in the software testing and verification department. I was a software engineer there. And in that position, I started to gain more and more experience and depth around software engineering. I had to work very closely with the developers to understand the requirements and the business needs. And from those requirements, I created different testing scenarios using different testing tools. One of the programming languages at that time was C++ that I used very heavily to create automated testing tools, automated testing scenarios. And then after that, I started to work very closely in running the formal design verification testing labs and to get more experience how to be able to run different smaller teams in creating tests and to execute those tests. After that, I had the chance to work in a mechanical and electrical project that helped to improve the quality of the products in the company I was working for. And in that specific role, I was a project manager, and that specific role helped me a lot in understanding how's the world outside the software area behaves, what's going there, what's the full complete story and picture. So once you are inside certain area or industry, you tend to believe maybe sometimes that everything is evolving around your center or around your role. But once you play different roles, you start to understand what does it mean from different perspectives. And then I joined Chablik Technologies here as project manager.
So if your job progresses as you like, what would be the next step in your career?
Let me answer you different about not only my career. I'll give you what does the software engineering career development looks like. And in this case, you start as an entry level in software engineering, working with a lot of project managers who will give you really clear and defined tasks as you get out of college, which are, I can't say easy, but very clear to implement within very known time box. And then as you start to get more experience, you become more of a senior engineer, where you start to deal with different roles or different tasks that have a lot of uncertainties, a lot of risks, a lot of unclarity that you have to reveal to yourself and to explain and understand to other people and to yourself as well. And that eventually will lead to a role where you are more of a principal or advisor in the area that you're working in. You became really the expert, the subject matter expert that can help a lot in solving really much more complex technical problems. And eventually you can get into chief technical officer, where you set the vision of a certain company, how it moves on. Other area that you can become expert in the software engineering is how to manage those projects, how to be able to help the team discover their risks, discover their timeline, plan better, and that is another area that you can move on and eventually can become part of a project management office in a certain company or director of project management that can help the company set certain portfolio and understand how its resources being used, what's the timeline, what's the budget for all the projects that the company is moving or trying to develop.
So what sorts of changes are occurring in the field of software engineering?
There are a lot of changes. They are countless. I can think of three changes that's happening. A big move into web application versus desktop application is one area. Another area is outsourcing. And one of the biggest areas I've been seeing is moving into agile process development or agile software development. And I can elaborate more about agile software development. It is a different way. I'll give you what's the classical way of doing software development, where you have, they call it waterfall model. You start with really analyzing and understanding the business need, creating clear requirements, and this will end the requirement phase. Then you start into design based on your requirements, and then you move to another phase, which is the implementation and the actual coding. And finally, you get into integration and testing before you close your loop and release. In agile software development, it's a little bit different. You try to break your whole project into smaller chunks of 2 weeks. They call it iteration. Sometimes they are 2 weeks, 3 weeks, depending on the business need and into the complexity of the project. And then on each iteration, you try to be able, by the end of each iteration, to demo to your customer. And most of the times, it's an internal customer that you have a very good package of a workable or deliverable software. You should be able, within that iteration, to have a clear requirements for that phase. You have clear design, implementation, and integration with whole verification and testing. So that is a hot area, in my opinion. And this one is applicable to some industries, but not to everyone. I can think of medical industries. Sometimes you can't just ignore the details of the process, the big process around a lot of stuff, that because you need to refer to those processes that cause you to take certain decisions. You need to refer them maybe 10 years down the road because you are really into a regulated industry. Versus if you are into high pace, very quick type of industry where you can develop something, release it, and then the whole technology changes within 2-3 months, and then you don't care about it anymore, you move to the next level or next phase.
From your perspective, what are the challenges of working in this field?
There are countless challenges in the area of software engineering. One of the challenges that just come to my mind right away is customer changing their mind. You'll always see, even if you set expectations with customers, deliver certain prototypes, get everything on paper and signed, that after you get all this prep and nice work, customers will keep changing their minds, and you have to adapt, you have to understand, you have to, because you have to be always open-minded. And the causes of those changes can be just the customer didn't understand what they really want, and then as you move on, they realize more what they need. Or just the industry itself changed. What was important yesterday is not important today, or 6 months down the road, or 2 months down the road. The change of the technology itself being used, and the type of programming languages, the type of processes or development methods and guidelines, those are changing very quickly. We don't have in the software engineering a immature field or industry compared to other industries. And this is actually adding to the fun of it, that there isn't always the best or the right way. People can be creative and just try and see how they can deliver their highest quality and innovative solutions in different ways. So those different changes are always fun, but add to the complexity of the field.
Well, how has your job affected your lifestyle?
I don't think that your job should affect your lifestyle. You should define your lifestyle yourself. You should be able to set your expectations or know what you want to do in life and don't let your job guide it. But nevertheless, in software engineering, sometimes you get a lot of stress, sometimes you get a lot of pressure that will affect your lifestyle. Me personally, I evaluated more what time means, the importance of time, because of the field I'm working in. My dad used to tell me time is really, really important, and took me some time to believe what he's saying. And from my own experience, I started to develop that time is what I really appreciate more in my lifestyle.
How would you describe your working atmosphere and the people with whom you're working with?
In one word, it's great. The reason for that, within Shavlik, we have very high professional people. One of the smartest I ever worked with. The nice thing, or one thing that happens a lot in software engineering, because it's very high pace and a lot of things changes very quickly, people may get frustrated very quickly or easily. And the nice thing I see with the people I'm working with, even with all the pressure we are having, all the changes we see on a daily basis, people keep their professionalism at really high level. We may disagree in a meeting room around the best way to do something, but everyone understand and keep in their mind that we are a team. Everyone is driving for the excellence and the success of the team. So disagreements or disapproval of points around, between the team doesn't mean that is just we disagree for the purpose of disagreeing. So we keep ourselves focused what we are trying to achieve as a team, and everyone challenges any point or idea is put on the table. No one, because of their title or because of their position, can put something on the table that the team will say, yeah, I believe, without thinking and challenging that, because everyone is smart and has an idea that can be applicable or implemented in a different way.
What organizations and associations would you recommend that would be helpful in your professional development?
There are more than one organization. Two organizations I can think of was IEEE and PMI, the Project Management Institute. The IEEE have a lot of different chapters that you can join in different societies. Computer engineering, software engineering is one of the areas where you can interact a lot with people within the states. Within each state, there is a chapter for that. And PMI, in my specific role, has a lot of project management professionals who are part of it, who share certain ideas, answer different questions, and have a lot of activities that you can join.
Okay, for my last question, do you know any other professionals working in software engineering who I should talk to?
Yeah, definitely. There are a lot of people that I can give you their contact info. We would love to meet you, give you some ideas and suggestions, some advices around their experience and how fresh new graduate students can get into this field.
Thank you.